How long should water be electrolyzed by passing through 100 amperes current so that oxygen released can completely burn 27.6 gram of diborane? So you know diborane is B2S6. When it is completely burned in oxygen, we get B2O3 plus H2. First we balance it, B2 borona balance hydrogen 3H2, so total 3O2. That means we need 3O2 with respect to 1 B2S6. Now, diborane is 27.66 gram. So, what is molecular weight of B2S6? 10.8 of boron. So, 10.8 into 2 means 21.6 plus 6. So, it is 27.6 means almost it is 1 mole. So with respect to 1 mole, oxygen required are 3 mole. So 3 mole oxygens are required. And when we electrolyze water, we get 4H plus plus O2 plus 4 electron. That means 1 mole of O2 require 4 mole of 1 mole electron. For 1 mole O2, we require 4 moles of electrons. So, but we need 3 moles of O2. So to get 3 mole of O2, we require 4 into 3 means 12 mole of electrons. So 12 mole of electron means 12 into 96,500 coulomb. This is the charge required, and that is equal to I into T. Now I into T, I is 100 time in seconds. So time is equal to 12 into 965 seconds. So now, but we need time in hours. So to get time in hours, we divide it by 3600. So just 36 into 100. 12 threes are. So it comes out to be 321 something. That means in divide by 100, so it is 3.21 hours. So right option is second. Okay, the compound that does not produce nitrogen gas by the thermal decomposition is, this is very easy question from, it is from NCERT. You know, in thermal decomposition of ammonium dichromate, we get nitrogen gas Cr2O3 along with H2. In ammonium nitrate we get N2 gas and H2. Actually in NCERT reaction is given ammonium chloride plus sodium nitrite. So in this reaction first we get ammonium nitrite and NaCl, and then ammonium nitrate give N2 and H2. Ammonium sulfate, when it is decomposed, we get ammonia gas and H2SO4. Barium azide, this is the best pure, in this case pure nitrogen is formed. We get barium as a solid and nitrogen gas. So in these three cases, even sodium azide give nitrogen. The pure nitrogen is formed by azide, right? So 1, 2, 3, in this case we get nitrogen gas, and this is the right option because it does not produce nitrogen gas. Fifth question is, an alkali is titrated against an acid with methyl orange as indicator. Which of the following is the correct combination? So now, you know methyl orange. Methyl orange has two forms. Benzenoid form is yellow. And quinonoid form, that is red. So yellow form is in basic medium and quinonoid form is in acidic medium. So if we compare these, you know, in base alkali, methyl orange is added in alkali. So in alkali it is yellow in color. So there is one, only one option where yellow is written. And when it is titrated against acid, it turns into quinolone form, and that is red, or we can say pinkish red. So only one option is there. So this is very easy question.